Hello, and welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes from MAKERDEMY.
And I'm Venkatesh, the founder of MAKERDEMY.
In this episode, we will take a look at the career opportunities available in IoT. Before we begin, let us take a look at the building blocks of an IoT solution. Things, connect, collect, learn, and do. We start with the things, and we connect them to the Cloud IoT platform and collect sensor data. Then we analyze this data, come up with actionable insights, and craft solutions based on these insights. Simple, right? Not really. Let us take a big picture, top-down view of an IoT solution. To start with, we need domain or industry experts. For example, if you are going to build a smart city, we need an expert who understands urban planning and policymaking. We will also need various functional specialists related to the domain for which we are building a solution. For instance, if you are building a jet engine as a service business, we are creating a new business model and most likely we will be disrupting the existing business model. We will need the inputs of the sales professionals to know what kind of solutions are acceptable by the clients. We'll also need someone from finance to see whether there is actually a return on the investment that we will make. Coming to the technical side, we'll go from left to right. First, things. Things are typically constrained devices. We will need embedded engineers who are both comfortable working with hardware and also with an ability to program these constrained devices. Knowledge of a low-level language like C, or increasingly even a high-level language like MicroPython, is essential. Next, we come to connect. Here, we would require engineers who understand how the internet works. Not only the internet, but also other wireless technologies like the BLE, ZigBee, LoRa, and so on. We would also need engineers who understand application-level internet protocols like MQTT and CoAP. We would then need professionals who specialize in IoT security. Such a person would be proficient in cryptography and security protocols. Next, we come to collect. Here, we need data scientists and AI/ML professionals. Here, the responsibilities would involve collecting the data, cleaning the collected data, and organizing this data. While all this may look boring and tedious, these steps are required before you use AI/ML techniques on the data. After that, we move on to learn. Here, we need professionals who can build ML models, analyze the data, and tease out actionable insights from the data. The last step is do. Here, we will require professionals who will implement the actionable insights. Our building blocks are actually very simplistic, and usually there are significant areas of overlap. Besides, we would need people who understand the APIs and can build web and mobile applications to visualize data. We would also need professionals who are experts in data visualization. Finally, we would need an IoT architect who is a full-stack IoT professional. This role is very critical and is responsible for understanding the problem statement and architecting the entire solution. Usually, in any team, we find a large number of specialists who specialize in machine learning algorithms or embedded programming. The more curious and ambitious professionals among these would eventually graduate to the role of an IoT architect, provided he has the aptitude and interest to learn and understand the different building blocks of the IoT system, most of which will be out of his area of expertise. That is all from me in this video, folks. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button and ring the bell so that you do not miss out on our future videos.